I don't care what you say anymore. This is my video and Zach's. But I'm taking the lead because I'm showing him. Yeah.
Aggressive, but...
So, yeah, I know, very aggressive. Anyway, guys, to the Billy Joel fans who tuned in for Turn the Lights Back On and We Didn't Start the Fire, welcome back. So, for those who saw We Didn't Start the Fire, that was the first time, basically, well, Zach doesn't know basically anything about Billy Joel, essentially. He only really knew Uptown Girl.
I know he's a legend.
This.
Okay, I know he's a legend.
Heard Piano
I know he's
Man.
Fucking incredibly talented.
He went back and listened to Vienna. And Piano Turn
Man.
The Lights Back On from New
Turn
Music
Turn the Lights
Friday.
Back On, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it. Now We Didn't Start the Fire, which I showed him, because he'd heard the Fall Out Boy rendition, and I showed him the thing, which actually was the first time I'd seen the actual video in full length, so it was new for me as well. And
it's
honestly, that went very well. People loved it. The amount
great
we
feedback.
Got about... I mean, I just read through before this video. We got about 30 different songs suggested from Billy Joel, like half his fucking catalog. Just suggested because turns out Billy Joel fans, they really want to see more. So welcome back. Hopefully
Shout
this
Uncle
does
Seymour.
Catch on. Hopefully we bring you back. I saw that because we were looking through and I was thinking we want to get the big ones out of the way first because we're not going to be able to get through all of them. But
what,
I thought, we'll try and at
we'll
least
do,
get through the big ones.
What we'll do...
We'll try and at least get through the big ones.
You sound like a girl in her hoe phase. Sorry, not the right audience, okay? Because this is definitely adults and
whoa,
old people.
Whoa, whoa,
this is definitely older
whoa,
people.
Whoa.
I'm sorry, guys. It's the immature whoa. Brain. I'm sorry. It's right there. He makes
You're
worse jokes than me.
You're talking to married men. Come on.
Shout out.
And
hey.
Women.
Hey, man. Hey.
Shout out to the
Shout
married
to
couples in the chat.
Hey, marriage is a difficult thing, but it's great for society. So keep it going. Keep it rolling. Boo hookup culture. Boo. Anyway, yeah, Billy Joel, my
Andy.
Life. Billy Joel, my life, let's go.
Not that we're telling you can't sleep with somebody else, but...
I know, obviously.
It's a reference, you'll get it in a minute.
Oh. That's weird that it came up then.
Also, I just want to say, incredible live performance he did. I forgot which live performance it was. But it's one of my dad's favorite live performances was one of the ones he did of My Life. And basically, he was just playing effortlessly. He was just, like, really happy on the piano.
Let's go. I don't want to talk too much because I want
to
pay hyper-attention. Nice. What in the damn hip-hop? Yo, check it. So I was walking down the street. That's exactly you hear it, right?
So I was walking down the street with the
also,
gun in my
I know
hand.
This is weird, but that actually looks like Tom Petty.
It does. No, I was going to say as well.
Is that Tom Petty? That would be weird, if so. That would be really, really fucking weird because of what we just did. Let us, you know what? Hold on. I got to know now. It looks so much like him, it very well could be. Hold on. If it is, this is going to be a moment where like, what the fuck? Billy Joel and Stevie Nicks, sorry, I just saw that, it's wild.
I don't think so, no.
No, probably not. Let us know if it is, though. I'll just double check right here to see if there's any.
This weird Stevie Nicks right after we talked about Fleetwood Mac. What the fuck?
And
dude,
then right.
This
yeah.
is... We got a.
It's weird. Oh, this
the
is.
Wrong video.
I started playing Caesar! We're not there yet, guys. We're not. That's next video.
Spoiler alert, guys. We're recording
video.
Two Billy Joels back to back.
Yeah, so. Fucking fourth wall. That was like a little time travel moment. Wouldn't that be funny? Wouldn't that be funny though if one day we just titled them the wrong way around and we just like did the opposite? Anyway.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Oh. Check it. Damn, you short. Shout out my short.
Well,
kings.
I was walking down to 52nd Street.
All right, let's push.
And there was a lovely little girl. Whoa. Checking me out. She was 18. Don't worry. I was 20.
Okay, good.
Have my backpack on and my leather jeans and what the fuck, leather jeans? I meant leather jacket.
All right.
What's cracking?
I hate to be.
My name is Billy. I'm silly.
I have to be a hater, but you gotta stop. You're gonna annoy the fucking.
Dylan,
viewers.
You gotta be quiet while I'm singing.
We gotta go. We gotta get through this. Be quiet. I wanna listen to the song. Is the song quality fucked up because of the video? How bad is it? Bad enough to just swap to the audio?
Maybe. I mean, I haven't seen the video, but I don't know.
I want to hear the song, too. Anyway, let's go. Hopefully the song is better quality than this.
It is.
What do we do?
We'll react to this as the video, but, like, I don't know, I guess.
Yeah, but are people going to get pissed off if they're like, we wanted you to hear the song, and then I listen to the shitty version of it, and they're going to be like, motherfucker, this is the wrong version.
Yeah, okay, maybe play another version then. I don't know.
I'll see if there's like a lyric video. Sorry we can't do the video right now. Okay, I'm sorry. Maybe we'll...
When you
Well, the video is... Well, this is Billy
when
Joel...
When you travel with... I'm not shouting at the company because
no,
fuck you,
that.
You gotta give us money for the ads.
Yeah, absolutely.
Money. Yeah, that's much better.
Much better is an understatement. Those chords are weird. It almost sounds like they don't work together, but they do. Got a call from an old friend. We used to be
real close. I don't know if you remember, but one time we were doing Ox Wars, and I actually picked this song as one of the
No, I don't remember.
Things.
But also, that's actually great. You guys want to see Ox Wars, where we pick images and pick songs, and then we'll do that in a live stream one day. We're going to do a live one day. You guys should check it out. We're going to do Ox Wars in a live stream. And we'll do polls for them.
Oh, my God, what we could do is we could have... We could have, like, random viewers or whatever. We just have like, an inbox of some sort,
right? Yeah, for them to add images.
And they literally just send us, like, a bunch of images or whatever, and we have to do Ox Wars to them.
And then
that would actually be really cool.
And then we'll run polls for them to pick the winner out of us two. Let's see who wins. Or we can do what the one streamer did where he pitted his audio, its members against each other. So there's, like, a website or something you can use, and they all pick songs, and then you figure out who wins. That's not a bad idea either. Let us know down below if you guys want us to do that. You guys too. Everyone can be a part of it. Basically, all it is, for those who don't know, it's just random pictures.
We're gonna unite the Billy Joel and Taylor Swift audience.
Yeah, everybody has to pick a song that fits that image, and then whatever song fits the image best wins.
Is it over now?
Either way,
I'm an Italian restaurant.
I'm gonna piss you off.
No, it's fucking.
Dylan, I'm gonna piss you. I'm gonna piss you off. You ready? The drum sounds exactly like Dreams. Drum and bass.
Does not sound exactly like.
Watch this. You ready? Wait. What's the first line of Dreams? Oh. It's very similar. Anyway, I want to pay attention to this song.
After each segment, pause, maybe.
I am. I'm watching the clock, bud. Hey, what year did this song come out?
78.
Yeah, I could tell 70s. I knew it was 70s. Yeah. Anyway. Need you to worry for me, 'cause I'm all right. nice acoustic guitar. It's hidden in there, but it's there. He didn't paint his vocals, that's weird. Nice backing. I never said I was a victim of circumstance. I still belong. Don't get me wrong. I really like the backing vocals. Like the choir or whatever that is. I think it's just him doubling himself, but it sounds great.
Here's the line I was referring to.
Wait, but listen to this production detail. He's going tss, tss, tss. He's doing it with his own mouth. Listen to the tss, tss, tss. Here. You hear it? You hear that, right?
Yeah.
Under the whole song. But sooner or later you sleep in your own space. Either way, it's okay. You wake up with yourself. I don't need you to worry for me. I'm really liking the flexibility of the song, as in like it's like the drums and it's kind of slowing down. It'll be like that piano melody, and then it'll be like the chords and then the backing, and then you have the drum.
Yeah, it's not one note. That's the main thing I love about it. I love the way it goes between like the main verse and chorus melody, and then into the post chorus as well. Like the post chorus is arguably my favorite part of the song.
I'm just doing this so I can do this like right at the end of the song, so I can just double check the lyrics and just glance over it one last time.
But total eclipse of the heart.
It's having a resurgence for some reason.
Because of the eclipse.
Oh. This is my life. Go ahead with your own life. I love those chords. Ooh. Minor chords. Ooh, I've never heard him use a chest voice like that before. Every time I've heard him sing, it's always like pretty lighthearted singing, but he kind of uses a little bit of that.
Hey, he can sing.
Below. Yeah, wrong. I mean, I knew that, I just... I want to let this run out, and because of copyright, the timing, it's going to work perfectly, let it run out all the way from here. But I just... Actually, I will say this for the outro. I will say this. I don't care what you say anymore. This is my life. Go ahead. Oh, do you remember that lyric? Leave me alone. He said, fuck off. Excuse my language, I'm sorry. This was actually a rarity where I actually do like the fade out. I don't usually like fade outs from back in the day. I don't like the way they do it. Also, I do want to, that's cool. Want to watch that video. Anyway, relevant. All right. Since this is mostly me in these type of videos, because you've already heard them all, it's mostly me, but I have a lot to say, so don't worry. The piano chords were fucking awesome. I've never heard, I keep cussing, I'm trying not to cuss because I know my audience is. But, like, the chords are amazing. Just the tonality of them especially. There's, like, it's clearly sections. So there's different parts where different instruments, like, take the lead. Like, you have the corded piano, and then you have the singular notes on the piano, and then you have the drum kind of takes the lead. And then you have another section where it's, like, the choirs in the background, like, his voice, the doublers, will take the lead. And I'm forgetting there was another instrument that took the lead, of course, how it opens. So it's, like, it's very versatile, and in every area that it does something different, it nails it. The other thing I want to point out is that the production for the time period it was in is fucking wild. So, like, it is very good production ahead of its time. Like, I know that, like, a lot of old songs like this had great production. It's just, anytime I hear a song from, like, the 70s or something, or even the 80s, that has, 80s less, but 70s a little bit more, that has, like, really good production, it's impressive just because of how much more difficult it was to achieve during that time period. The 80s, there was kind of, like, a big, like, I guess, burst of technology, but in the 70s it was significantly more difficult to be able to nail it that well.
One of the biggest transitional eras for, like,
the 80s and then the 2000s. The 2000s
production was a big time, like, and it sort of started in the late 70s, like around this sort of
yeah
era, but it was more so in the, like, early to mid 80s that it really,
the Michael Jackson, the Billie Jean era. The Billie Jean, and even
that
further
era,
in
basically
even a little bit past Billie Jean, but yeah.
And hell, I remember, like, I know Brothers in Arms by Dire Straits in 1985 was, like, the first to be released on, I forgot what it was called, but, it was just to be, released on a certain format or whatever.
Probably CD.
Which is part of the reason why it sold so much,
Probably CD.
But, I thought CDs were around before that,
I don't think they were, no. It was records. Let us know down below. You guys would probably know. But I fucking loved it. It's amazing. Cussed again, sorry. A lot. I liked it. It's definitely up there. The more I hear Billy Joel, just the more I realized he's goated. Like, every time I hear a new Billy Joel song, I'm like, this motherfucker did not mess around. I cussed again. He did not mess around at all. He was goated. Everything that he did was good. I don't know how much instrumentation he's responsible for, but it doesn't matter. It all sounds great.
I mean, I know the piano is him.
Yeah, we know that.
The piano's him. I know the songwriting is primarily him. Like, he does most...
If only there was some magical website in which we could figure out how it was produced. If only. If only we could check who did everything. The clarinet. That's interesting.
Oh, so it was written solely by him. He was the sole writing. He was the sole vocals.
Thormone was the producer.
Piano was solely him.
Who was responsible for the drums? Liberty. We love looking, obviously. You guys can't see this, just because I don't have it pulled up. But you can see who... Okay, Billy Joel's drummer. Figured that out. Got it. We didn't see the drummer on Vienna.
That's actually one cool
Uptown
thing.
Uptown Girl. Yeah, he's their drummer.
Most
he's
of
drummer.
Them. And Scenes, actually, as well, which is ironic.
What about Doug Stagmeier? Okay,
one
Billy Joel's bassist.
Right?
This motherfucker had the same band for a long time.
No, before you go through all of them, because you're just going to repeat yourself otherwise, he had basically the same instrument. Like,
wrong.
He had the same people on the instruments for most of the time.
This was the exception. But yeah, you're right.
Most of the instruments he rocked with pretty much from... literally the first album. He kept the same people on instruments right through, which, because my dad was talking about it, how, like, he's been touring with the same, like, instrumentalists since the 70s and still does even to this day.
Okay, so this guy, so this drummer didn't do all of his songs, obviously. He did a few pretty interesting ones for sure. Like, he did a lot of Billy Joel songs. My Life, The Stranger.
Oh, he did The Stranger.
Vienna. He played guitar on those songs. But yeah, yeah, great song. Terrific. Dylan, I think we've covered everything we need to cover. We have some more Billy Joel videos coming out soon. Obviously, we kind of spoiled one today.
Just to recap mine, basically, my thoughts on it, basically, yeah, classic. Love the details. One of the best I've heard from him, but I still got to go through some of his more deeper cuts. However, yeah, no, obviously, I love it, so.
Well, Dylan, and then I think it's where you say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye, fellas.